Okay, good morning, everybody. Yeah, on behalf of the Risk Society and the Policy Research Center, I would like to welcome all the colleagues join this very significant forum about the transition in Taiwan or in the world. So particularly, I would like to express my gratitude to our distinguished guest, Professor Naki, far from European, and our two important discussants, Professor Dim Wu and Ms. Zhou. Before I formally introduce the keynote speaker and the discussant, I would like to stress a short open remark. So, okay, let us show the standpoint of Taiwan or the country in East Asia. We see that China ranked at the first one of the carbon emissions in the world. China contributes about 9,800 million tons CO2 emission. And Japan ranked at fifth in the world. Japan contributes about 1,200 million tons, and Korea, South Korea is ranked at the seventh and contributes 616 million tons. And for Taiwan, the per capita is 10.8 in 2008. By over 10 million population nations, Taiwan ranked at S. So we can see that not only Taiwan, most of the East Asia countries are high carbon economic bodies or high carbon society. This is our standpoint. And usually I would like to say that for the energy or the climate change transition or transformation that Taiwan first faced the vertical pressure from international green convention, particularly after the COP21. And we also face the challenge by the horizontal pressure that our society requests more and more clean energy and industry. And by under this vertical and the horizontal pressure, actually, I call it the triple helix movement. We face some challenge. The first spiral that is the energy fuel selection, whether we select coal-fired, LNG, nuclear, of renewable that's related to carbon emission and related to the debate at the nuclear risk. And secondly, in Taiwan, we still have the very heavy or the energy intensive industry, for example, the petrochemical industry. This must be reformed. Otherwise, it is abstract the Taiwan's transformation. And the third component or the third spiral is air pollution. We know everyone concerned about PM2.5. Everyone think about whether we can actually change another energy fuel. So this is actually the very entanglement of the triple helix movement of energy of the climate change movement in Taiwan. So normally we see in the world there are two main upper streams of global development. The first upper stream is AIoT. The second upper stream is carbon reduction, but mostly our government, our industry elite, likely to focus on AIoT development, but seriously ignore the carbon reduction. Normally, they look carbon reduction as environmental problem, not the social transition or the industrial future industrial problem. So this is the problem. The problem. I would like to say that Taiwan's climate and energy transition is far lagging behind in the other world. But our state, industry, and the society is still indulged in the brown economic package. What caused that is brown economic package. Let me indicate that. For a long time, we actually focus on the economic-oriented development. We neglect the non-economic growth indicator, for example, labor rights, environmental rights, gender rights, something like that. So the components of the brown economy, so-called brown economy, are the low wage, low environmental expenditure, externalization of the environmental cost, and we still have the fossil fuel subsidies by the government. And actually, Taiwan's ranked that at the sixth lowest of industrial electricity price in 2008, and the seventh lowest of the household electricity price in the world. For this brown economic package, we have the to be supported by brown economic coal fire and nuclear. So normally in Taiwan, over Taiwan debate whether we go this way or this way, but we actually have to be beyond the brown economic package or the framework. So everyone discuss about whether we should to initiate the nuclear power or not. This is still by the low electricity price imagination. So the characteristic of Taiwan industry is that if we to go further, when Taiwan faced the fourth industrial revolution, we have to transit many sectors, industrial sector, energy sector, social sector, and health sector, and also aging society sector. So we actually meet the very serious challenge. But the Taiwan's characteristic of the industry is that we enjoy the low growth margin, low cost competition, but we are flexible, adaptable, and fast-learning contract manufacturer model. But this old paradigm, supported by brown economy, could not be exempt by the new world, by the new first industrial revolution. For a long time, I said that Taiwan is actually indulged in systematic stagnation. We are lazy transition by the governments. We are lazy transition by the industry. We are lazy transition by the society. This is the whole picture of imagination of the society, of the region. So the representative model is that our national industrial coalition or association usually stressed so-called five shortage, 五缺, that they urge the government have to tackle the problem of lack of water, electricity, labor, land, and the skilled workers. But actually, this is a pastel. This is a false issue. Because this so-called five shortage issue supported by the low electricity price, low water price, low labor price. So you can see this is also by support by the brown economic package. So we have to transform. We have to transform. So in the world, we see that there are two S-curve development, social development curve. One curve, roughly we said, is the low carbon economic S-curve. Another curve is the brown economic curve, S-curve. So we still actually enjoy or indulge in the brown, when we still indulge in the brown economic curve, we will actually have the development far behind the global trend. So this is very important. So I will show some picture. You can see this cover story by a magazine several years ago. This is related to the generation justice. And actually this is March occurred in 2013 after Fukushima accident. So many people expressed that way. And this is a debate in 2010-2011 whether Taiwan continues to construct the S petrochemical fabric, 国光石化. This is a great debate. You can see that the different sounds from the stakeholder. So this is actually made by the young group that want to mobilize the people, go out to express their concern. So following this great challenge of the social contested issue, actually we have to learn some new paradigm from abroad. This is the very important flagship report released or published by WGO, Germany Climate Change Council, called Water in Transition, a Social Contract for Sustainability. And the Professor Nakić at that time was the committee members about of the WGO. So this is very important issue that German government try to make the very clear roadmap how their society transit their climate, their energy, and their urban, even land use. So this is a very important flagship. So now that today we will talk about transformation to SDG. So now we also have the challenge about that. So by following the WGU's flagship report, recently we will also publish our center's research report called Taiwan in Transition, Initiating a Long-Term Energy Transition. So we try to actually urge or advocate our government, our society, to make our roadmap clear. So we set some different targets. By the low target or the middle target, that is only follow the target setting by our Carbon Reduction and the Management Act. By this act, in 2030, we have to reduce our carbon emission to the 2005 level, minus 20%. And to the 2050, we have to reduce our carbon emission to the 2005 level, minus 50%. But whether this is only the legal setting, so this we call it the low and the middle setting. Whether we can have the high setting, high target setting, whether we can have the carbon neutrality target in 2050. We know that Professor Nakić also published one article that discussed about whether renewable energy is renewable energy 100% renewable energy possible or not. So I think he will also give us some point in his keynote speech. So to the actually to the open remark, I would like to say we have to speed up our transformation by different way, and we actually have to actually concentrate our energy, our social development imagination and the future development imagination to catch up the whole global transformative trend. So this is my open remark. Thank you very much.